Well, hello again, all the boys and girls out there in YouTube land watching. Georgia Beer Reviews back at you today with another one. And what I'm looking at is a beer from Talespinner Brewery. This is Coosane. It's a New England-style IPA clocking in at 6.4% alcohol by volume. Talespinner Brewery is in Nashua, New Hampshire. They were established back in 2022, so relatively new brewery. Actually got to go to the brewery. It's a really cool setup. They're connected. The brewery is connected to a restaurant called the Rambling House. It's kind of like a steakhouse, and they have a lot of stuff. They have seafood. They have steak. They have pretty good stuff there. And the brewery is downstairs to the left, and it's just like this one room with four or five bar stools, and then you can see the door that leads into the brewery, and they have like three or four big vats that they brew the beer in, but it's a very small scale operation. They're just kind of getting started. Like I said, established back in 2022. They do distribute, however, to a couple of stores in New Hampshire. Don't distribute down here in Massachusetts yet. At least I haven't seen any of their stuff, but they do have some distribution in New Hampshire. Hopefully they'll do well and they'll expand, and we'll be able to get their stuff down here in my area. But anyway, bought a few 4-packs while I was there. This one is, like I said, New England style IPA, 6.4%. It was canned at the end of November, so not super, super fresh, but I got it at the brewery. These guys are just now kind of getting up and running, so it won't hold it against them too much. It's still within the 3-month range for what I like with my New England style IPAs. So let's pour it up and see what we're working with here. All right. It's a good looking beer. Good looking, juicy IPA. It is orange. Pretty hazy, but not completely opaque. When I hold it up to the light, I can see through it just a little bit on the bottom there. But nice, vibrant orange color. Two and a half finger, really. Slightly off-white, creamy looking head. The aroma with this one, very juicy. Tangerine forward. Definitely getting a little bit of pineapple with this one. There's also a little bit of like an earthy hop note with this. Some nice wheat, bready malt notes that you get with most IPAs, because wheat malt is a standard component in most IPAs. It smells pretty good. Of course, none of the alcohol is coming through at 6.4%. It smells nice and juicy, fresh and fruity. So without further ado, let's get into this brew. Cheers, guys. Yeah, that's really nice. It's interesting. The body with this is actually that of a lot of the double IPAs that I've been drinking. So it's got a nice, like, little bit of a viscosity to it. There's a lot of citrus flavor, a little bit of tropical fruit, mostly like pineapple, maybe a slight mango. Carbonation is medium. The body is really on the medium side, especially for 6.4% for a straight IPA, not a double here. It drinks more along the lines on most of the doubles that I've had. Yeah, nice wheat, bready malt note in the middle of the sip. It's got almost like a champagne effervescence to it, which is really nice. It's juicy all the way through, and then as you swallow it down, it's slightly drying, which is strange because it's lower alcohol than what I'm used to with these juicy IPAs. There's a little bit of like a lemon zest or pith. They're like a not great. It doesn't have a grapefruit flavor, but that pithy bitterness that you get with a lot of citrus fruits, that white part, the pith of the fruit itself, provides a lot of bitterness. And there's a little bit of that on the back end. Not to say that this is a extremely bitter beer. It's not at all. But it does have nice flavor notes. Nice juicy flavor notes initially. And then when you get to that finish, that little bit of bitterness kind of rounds everything out. Of course, none of the alcohol is present. It is medium-bodied, which I'm really impressed with the body with this for a standard IPA. It drinks above its ABV in terms of body for the style, which is really nice. I'm digging this a lot. I hope that Tailspinner Brewery does very well. They have some stiff competition in Nashua. In Spyglass. Spyglass Brewery makes some of the best juicy IPAs that I've ever had. So they've got their work cut out for them, but this is a good start. An excellent beer from Tailspinner. Coosane New England style IPA, 6.4% alcohol. Buy it, try it. Let me know what you guys think. Rating time. I probably should have done that before I gave out my ending buy it, try it thoughts there. Anyway, I'm going to go with a 95. It is a solid A beer, and I would highly recommend it. It's got good body for a standard juicy IPA. It's got nice head. It's got a creamy, fluffy, tight mouthfeel. A little bit of bitterness to round out some of the juicy notes. You're getting tropical fruit. You're getting citrus. A little bit of earthiness as well. Really a nice beer. So 95 out of 100 for Tailspinner Brewery's Coosane New England Style IPA. They're out of Nashua, New Hampshire. If you're ever in the area, please go check them out. Support your local breweries so that they can grow and distribute more. Because this is a great beer. I'd love to be able to get it here in Massachusetts. So that'll do it for this beer review, guys. 95 out of 100. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you can get this beer, if you've had it, what you think of it. And we'll see you right here, all in the next beer review. Until then, cheers, everybody.